I am Sandra Williams. I am the Department Chair of Electronic Engineering Technology Program at PCC Sylvania. The Electronic Engineering Technology Program has been around for over 50 years, and we produce high-quality technicians with great abilities and skills that have been seeking great jobs in the industry, and they also transferred to higher level institutions, four-year bachelor degrees.
The great thing about the EET program is the opportunity for students to be working with top-notch instructors who have a lot of experience in the field and have been working in this area, either in industry or in academia, for many years.
We offer one AES degree, Electronic Engineering Technology, that also has four areas of concentration. We call them options, EET options. And these options are biomedical engineering technology, wireless and data communication, mechatronics automation and robotics, and renewable energy systems. We also offer a career pathway certificate.
In the hybrid learning model, students get a combination of face-to-face and remote instruction. Face-to-face, in the hybrid model, it's a more traditional thing. Students would be working in teams, in pairs, very much like the actual engineering world, where pretty much all the work you do is going to be as a member of a team and working together.
We are testing our transistors to verify that they are good. This is an incredible class. If you're interested in this stuff, you learn so many fundamentals. I'm a technician, has a full-time job, and this has helped me a lot.
So here's pin 11. Right now we're taking some voltage measurements. I actually really love this class because we get hands-on experience.
How to use equipment, how to program, how to look at problems and how to debug them, how to approach problems. I use that stuff every day.
We were trying to confirm that the 5-volt connection between the control board and the paddle connection for the defibrillator. It's a lot of fun.
Good. Super fun.
You have to take stuff apart and put it back together. We like it a lot.
The total we do add.
We are working every day to make sure students have the best learning environment. We have a great team of faculty. Staff, administrators, everybody work hands in hands to make sure we meet the needs of our students.
The students right now, most of them are working on what we call the electronic die experiment. They create a counter that takes and steps through a series of six stages, like rolling a die, okay, and then randomly picks one of the numbers. It's kind of a fun one because it builds on everything that they've done up to this point, and it introduces a few new things. It introduces a new oscillator, and that's what we try to do with these labs all the way through, is that each time they're adding on something new to what they've learned before. The look that someone gets on their face when they finally get it working, they see those lights blinking in the right order, it's pretty amazing.
I am on my sixth lab, my electronic die. Right now I'm just arranging my LEDs to try to make it look like a die. So once I have all the components together, you push a button, it'll randomly generate the lights to turn on into a certain die combination. So you'll get that random number as if it was a real die. I love this class a lot, very hands-on.
I personally spent over 25 years working in the industry as electronic engineering. I love it. It's a fun field to be in. And here at PCC, you get the opportunity to learn the theory, you get to do the hands-on work, you get to see your actual circuits working, you do the troubleshooting, you get to do all the things in a little bit more sheltered environment that you would be doing out of the industry. It's a great opportunity.
Here at Intel, I am an engineering technician. I work with a handful of teams, FPGA developers, software developers, hardware developers. Growing up, I didn't have a lot of money, and my parents didn't save money for me or my sister to kind of go back to school and, go to university. I had to do research to go and figure out, what's going to be most cost effective, what will not put me so far into debt where I'm basically going to be spending the rest of my life paying it off. I eventually found PCC and their EET program, or Electronic Engineering Technology, and so I thought that'd be a really good fit for me, and sure enough it was. If you're into taking computers apart, working on apps for phones, or even just remotely interested in technology in general, how it works, you should definitely check out the PET program. It's super awesome, a lot of fun.
We also work a lot to offer flexibility to our students. So we are in the process of implementing hybrid courses where students can complete laboratory activities and lecture from home.
In either side of the hybrid model, whether it's remote or whether it's face-to-face, the student has the opportunity to work closely with the instructor face-to-face. The instructor is able to get in there, actually touch equipment, touch the circuitry, point out things directly to the students. Remotely, the student is doing that all themselves, but they have the ability then to get guidance from the instructor about what they're probing, what they're testing, what parts of the circuit they're going to look at.
They want you to understand the material. They want you to be successful because you're literally working on machines that can save people's lives.
In this class, we just work on a lot of like medical equipment, from like testing to...
Yeah, make sure it works. You know, that's the first thing. Does it work? If it doesn't work, then we look into it.
And once we get it to work, safety check every piece of equipment.
Yeah, you know, you don't want to give, you know, a patient a not working equipment, you know.
Right.
A lot of preventive maintenance, pretty much.
Yeah.
The goal is just to be like a clinical technician, just work in a hospital environment and work on medical equipment.
This is a defibrillator. Right now we're just taking it apart and putting it back together, you know, identify what part is what.
The way that we deal with the labs under a remote learning situation is students have a set of equipment and a set of parts that they take to their own homes, and they can build their circuits, troubleshoot them, working with the instructor. The instructor can look at photos that they take of their materials and look at it. And the advantage of this, of course, is that it means that every student is getting to build their own circuit.
Knowing, you know, with my time at PCC and the skill sets I learned within the EET program, it makes me happy to know, hey, I know something that I can teach someone else, or I can, you know, make the work environment a better place.
It's extremely rewarding. I am looking at our graduates and they are just amazing. They make a change in the society, and this is what I like the best about it.